Good morning, students. Welcome to the virtual class, students. Now, in the last lecture, we have already discussed about the combined gas equation, ideal gas equation, and the relation between the mass, volume, and density, volume and molar mass and density. Right? We already told that in the last lecture that we will be going through the numericals of those topics. Right? So let's do it as in few numericals of those topics. One by one, we will be doing it. Right? Again, make it sure that while you are doing these numericals, I am not going to calculate the final answer, because wherever required, I will put it ABC. You have to use your calculator and get the answers. Right? Second thing, make sure that whatever the numericals that I am doing it, they are the additional numericals other than the numericals that are given in your textbook, maybe solved or unsolved. Right? So make it as a note in your notebook also. Right, for those values that I am giving you. Right, now the first question that we are trying to solve for this one, that is, a question is given to us, a sample of nitrogen gas occupies a volume of 320 meter cube, centimeter cube at STP. Calculate the volume at 66 degree Celsius and 0.825 bar pressure. Right? Now see, what is given to us? It's told to me that the volume of a nitrogen gas, that means it's an N2 gas, that is given to me, nitrogen gas. It occupies 320 centimeter cube. So, can I write it from this? V1, 320 centimeter cube. Right? Now, this volume is occupied at what? STP. So, initial temperature will be 273.15 Kelvin. Pressure, that is equals to 1 bar. See, why I am taking it in the bar? The P2 is given to me in terms of bar. This is given to me in the Celsius, but I have to always complete it into Celsius, Kelvin. Already we studied it, Kelvin scale. In our chemistry, we will be always doing the numericals based on the temperature will be always taken in Kelvin. Right? So V1 is given to me, T1 is given to me, P1 is given to me. Now, it's told to me, calculate volume. So V2, we want to find out. T2, that is given to me, 66 degree Celsius, that is 273.15 plus 66. So that means you are going to get it as 339.15. P2, we have been given 0.825 bar. So, can I go for the combined gas equation P1 V1 upon T1, that is equals to P2 V2 upon T2. See, already as we know it, in the chemistry, once if I am able to identify what is the formula that I need it, then what I have to do it is, I have to simply place the values and get the answer. Values are given to me, 1, V1, 320, 273.15, P2, 0.825, V2 I want to find out, and T2 is 339.15. Therefore, V2 is equals to 1 into 320 into 339.15 upon 273.15 into 0.825. Calculate the answer, and answer you will get it as centimeter cube. That is the volume occupied by it. Right? It's a simple sum. Okay. Let's take it as one more sum. For a similar type of sum. Right? What is given to us in this sum? One mole of pure dinitrogen gas at STP conditions STP conditions was put into a vessel of volume 0.025 meter cube. Maintained at the temperature of 50 degrees Celsius. What is the pressure of the gas in the vessel? Now, they are this time asking me what is the pressure of the gas inside the vessel. Now, what are the terms that are given to me? First of all, I want to understand that equation. What are the terms that are given to me? Once if I am able to understand that factors, I can identify the equation, the formula that I will be using it. Right? So it is told to me number of moles, that is 1, STP. So standard temperature, that is T1, that is 273.15. Standard pressure, that is P1, that is 1 bar pressure is put. Now, this 1 mole of pure nitrogen gas at STP condition, right? So at that time, what would be the volume occupied by it? That is given to me, 22.71 liter, right? That much initially, 1 mole of pure nitrogen when it is occupying at an STP, the volume occupied by it is this much, that I have to identify it. It's told to me that this much volume when it was placed into the container, its volume becomes 0.025 meter cube. Now see, one is in the liter and one is in the meter cube. So one of the term I will have to convert it, right? At temperature T2, that is 50 degrees Celsius, that is 273.15 plus 50. So we are going to get it as 323.15 Kelvin. Right? And the pressure we want to find out. Now seeing these terms, it is already helpful to me that I am going to use it P1 V1 upon T1 is equals to P2 V2 upon T2. This is the equation that I am going to use it. But this term is given to me in the terms of liter and this one is given to me in the terms of meter cube. So first of all, I will have to convert this into liter. So what does it show? 1 meter cube is equals to 1000 liters. That we know it in the first chapter we did it. We did it as 1 decimeter cube equals to 1 liter and 1 meter cube equals to 1000 decimeters. So that means we will be getting it. The relation that we have studied it, 1 liter, that is equals to 1 dm cube and 1 meter cube is equals to 1000 decimeter cube. Therefore, 1 meter cube, that is equals to 1000 liters. This is a term that we will be getting it. So we will convert it. So what we will get it? 1 bar, volume 22.71, temperature 273.15, pressure P2 I want to find out, volume it's a 0.025 into 10 raised to 3, 0.025 into 10 raised to 3 and temperature is 323.15. Therefore P2 is 1 into 22.71, 273.15 into 323.15 upon 0.025 into 10 raised to 3. Calculate the answer and the answer will be in the terms of bar. Why we will be having the unit as in bar? The reason is we took it as initial pressure in terms of bar. So our unit over here will be also in the terms of bar. Okay? Great? Perfect. Let's take it as an another numerical, something different. Now, we did it as a similar type of an I combined gas equation numericals. will be there. Only the factor is the units will have to be checked, and the units you have to keep on in your mind, and you have to convert those units, right? Okay, the next one that we are having, we will go it for some questions for ideal gas equation, right? Rest for the combined gas equation, you can do it as a practice from the textbook also or from other reference book also. For this we have been given out how many moles of oxygen gas, oxygen are present in 400 centimeter cube sample of the gas at a pressure of 700 mmHg. At a temperature of 300 Kelvin. Now, this is given to us. How many moles of an oxygen are present? That means I want to go it for calculation of number of moles. Present in volume. Volume is given to me 400 centimeter cube. Right? Pressure, that is 700 mm of Hg, temperature 300 K, right? Now this is given to me and I want to calculate it, the number of moles. So I am going to use the equation as PV is equals to nRT, right? But what will be the value of R? 0.0831 liter bar per mole Kelvin, right? Okay, now let's check the values. This R is in the terms of liter bar mole Kelvin. Temperature is in Kelvin, so no need to change, will do. But this is given to me in mm of Hg and this is given to me in terms of bar. So what I have to do it is 1 mm of Hg, that is equals to 1 torr, right? So 700 mm of Hg, that is equals to 700 torr. At the same time, the relation we are having it, 1 bar is equals to 760 torr. So 700 torr, we will be getting it as 700 upon 760 bar. So our pressure is going to become as, the P we are going to use it as 700 upon 760 bar, right? T I am going to get it as 300 Kelvin. R we are having it 0.0831, right? Still the volume is there. Now here the volume is in liters, here it's in the centimeter cube, right? Now for that case, 1 centimeter cube, that is equals to 1 ml. So 400 centimeter cube, that is equals to 400 ml, or we will be getting it as 0.4 liter. 400 mm is 0.4 liter. So volume I am going to use it is 0.4 liter. See, this is what the importance of these numericals will be. Units you will have to convert it. Otherwise, the values are already there. You have to simply place it. But the units you will have to be very, very careful. Now using this equation, we will be putting it. PV is equals to nRT. N is equals to PV by RT. Substitute the value. You got it as 700 upon 760. Volume you got it as 0.4. R 0.0831. T that is 300 Kelvin. Simply make the calculation. You will get it as number of moles. This is what you will be, how to be careful while doing the numericals. Your unit should be perfectly checked. Right? Okay. Let's do it. The another similar type of sum. For the ideal gas equation itself, by using the ideal gas equation only, we'll try to do it one more numerical, right? The value for it, it's given to us. seen it. What is the question given to us? The discharging tube contains a nitrogen gas at 25 degrees Celsius. So temperature is given to me. T is equals to 25 degrees Celsius. That is 273.15 plus 25. That is 298.15 Kelvin. Temperature is given to me. Is evacuated in till the pressure. So P is given to me. 2 into 10 raised to minus 2 mm of Hg. Right? Okay. Volume of the discharging tube, that is 2 liters. Calculate the number of molecules. So we want to first of all find out moles. And then moles into 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 will give me molecules. So this is what we want to find out. Right? And the value of R this time is given to us, that you take it as 0.0821 liter atmosphere. That means your pressure is not necessary to be converted into bar or torr. It has to be converted into ATM, right? Atmospheric pressure. It's a liter atmosphere per mole Kelvin. So for this, what we are having is the relation 1 ATM. That is equals to 760 mm of Hg. Therefore, we have been given out 2 into 10 raised to minus 2. So what will be ATM? 2 into 10 raised to minus 2 upon 760 ATM. Right? So pressure, we are going to use it as 2 into 10 raised to minus 2 upon 760. So we are going to get it as an equation. PV is equals to nRT. N is equals to PV by RT. PV got it as 2 into 10 raised to minus 2 upon 760. Volume 2 liters. Gas constant 0.0821. Temperature 298.15. We got it as moles. Alright? See, if you make it as an error for calculating it as an the units, if your units are wrong, what will happen? Your calculation will become wrong. So make it sure that you go it respectively to the units. Right? We got it as number of moles. 1 mole contains 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 molecules. We are having it as an E moles. Make your calculation using the calculator. Get the answer. You will get it as E into 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 molecules of N2 gas. That is our final answer. Right? Got it? These are the numericals that we did it on the basis of ideal gas equation. Two numericals we did it. Right? Now we will make it as a practice to find out what is the density and ideal gas equation having in relation with it. How can, by using the density, what is the formula change that we will be doing it. Till now we were using it only the equation as PV is equals to nRT. See, in the last theory we derived it as D density is equals to PV by nRT, mRT, right? Or we also got it as P is equals to rho RT by mV, the formula. So just converting it. We will be using those formulas. Right? We are having it as a numerical that is given to us in the form of density of certain gaseous oxide. At 1.5 bar pressure at 10 degrees Celsius is seen as that of dioxygen at 20 degrees Celsius and 4.5 bar pressure. calculate the molar mass of gaseous oxide. Okay, now see, this is given to us, density of a certain gaseous oxide at this. So density of gaseous oxide, it's told to me, density of gaseous oxide is equals to the density of oxygen gas, right? But the condition is given to me that it should be at this temperature, pressure and volume. So for gaseous oxide, temperature, it's given to me 10 degrees Celsius, that is 283.15 Kelvin. Pressure 1.5 bar. Volume is same. Volume is same, right? Molar mass, I want to calculate it. Now, for this, we have been given a temperature 20 degrees Celsius, that is 293.15 K. Pressure 4.5 bar. Volume and number of mole mass, that is not given to us, we are going to consider it as same. Molar mass is 32 gram per mole. This is oxygen, so O2, so we are going to get it as 32 gram per mole. So can I get the equation? This one I'm going to get it as PV is equals to nRT, substitute the N, we get it as M by capital MRT. Capital M is equals to small MRT by PV. M by V, that is equals to density. This is for gaseous oxide, right? Okay, now take this, we will be getting it as again the same, we will be getting it here PV is equals to nRT, N is equals to M by capital MRT PV. So we will be getting it here P is equals to N by V MRT, this is again rho density, D by MRT. So can I write this as D is equals to PM by RT, right? Now this equation and this equation, I want to calculate the molar mass of an unknown substance, but it is told to me density of oxide is equals to density of oxygen gas. So can I substitute this value over here? So from equation 2, in the equation 1, if I put it, M is equals to P of O2, M of O2, R of O2, T of O2 into R T by P of unknown, that is gaseous oxide, right? What we will be getting it? So let's get it as a the values to be placed, right? Now let's place the value in the given equation. This M P of O2, P of O2 is 4.5 bar, molar mass of O2 32, R of O2 it's 0.0831, T temperature, that is 293.15, into again R of unknown gas, R is going to remain same, temperature it's a 10 degree, that is 283.15 upon P, that is 1.5 bar. Now you can go for the calculation using your calculator, get your answer. This is the gram per mole, that is the molar mass of gaseous oxide. This is the molar mass of the gaseous oxide. See what we did it. Simply, first of all, we use the formula, place the values, get the answer. So it is important that you are able to identify the formula for the given sums, right? Would you like to do it one more? Let's do it. One more similar type of sum, right? What is given to us for this sum? It is given to us density of a gas. Is found to be .46 gram per decimeter cube at 300 Kelvin and 2 bar pressure. What will be the density at STP? So this time the gas is given to us is a same density of a gas is given to me, but I want to calculate the density of a gas at STP. So first of all, density is equals to formula PV is equals to nRT. This is a common equation. NV to get as M upon mRT. So P is equals to M by V mRT. So from this we got it as, this is the formula that we are going to have it. Now let's apply the formula. I want to calculate the density, so I will make it as an sub. First of all, I will have to find out the what for it, molecular mass of a given substance. From this it's told to me M is equals to dRT by P. It's given to me, density is given to me 5.46 R 0.0831 T 300 Kelvin P 2 bar. So I will get it as molecular mass gram per mole. First of all, I will get it as a molecular mass of that unknown gas. Now I want to put it as a density at STP. So density at STP. So formula will become as D is equals to PM by RT. According to this formula, we will get it as D is equals to PM by RT. D is equals to P is given to me at STP. That means 1 bar. Molecular mass, I will get it over here. R 0.0831. And T again at STP. So it's a 273.15. Substitute the value and you will get it as gram per decimeter cube. Don't make it as an error for writing the unit of the density, because we kept it over here, gram per centimeter cube, decimeter cube, gram per decimeter cube. So this one will remain as gram per decimeter cube only. Okay. So these are the different numericals or the different formulas, how we just twisted it, how we convert it from one form to the another form, and we saw the certain numericals. Make the practice of this type of numericals. In our next lecture, we will study about the Dalton's law of partial pressure and kinetic molecular theory, and we'll do it further topics in our next lecture. Thank you.